Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today is going to be my February favorites. I can't believe we're already in March. This is insane. But I hope you guys are having a great 2016 so far. I know I've had an awesome year and there's so much that's gonna be changing in the next couple months. So I'm super excited. If you haven't seen any of my social media stuff, I'm planning to move in a couple months. So I'm actually going to LA later this week to apartment shop. I really hope I can at least get an idea and find some stuff that I like. I'm super pumped, but yeah. So let's go ahead and get into the makeup. By the way, my mood necklace is totally giving me like high school vibes. I actually got this because I just thought it was cute, but it was purple earlier. I wish it would go back to the like purple color because that was really pretty. So my first favorite is the new Hidden Treasures palette from Dose of Colors. This palette is beyond gorgeous. Like, it has the perfect mix of matte and shimmery eyeshadows. I did a look with it this weekend using only the matte colors because when I try a new palette, I usually tend to try the matte colors first because I use those more on a daily basis. So I use the brown, the beige, and the black when I did a matte look this weekend. And then the shimmery colors are so intense and so pigmented. Like, they're insane. Like, you just barely swatch your finger in there and like, do you see that? You see this rose gold color right here? Like, barely dipping my finger. You see that? The color is so intense. Let's do the burgundy one. Like, they're so metallic. And then the black is so black. Like, look at that. Do you see how intense those are? They're insane. This is becoming one of my new favorite palettes because it's just the perfect warm, foiled, especially summertime palette. As summer rolls around, this is just gonna be my baby. I'm gonna be wearing it all the time because you can do all kinds of looks with it. You can do more of a glam look with the foil colors, or you can keep it more matte for like a daily basis. And I am just in love with it. And they're so blendable and easy to use. Like, I'm really, really, really impressed with this and I can't wait for them to make more, but this is the Dose of Colors Hidden Treasures palette. So my next palette is the Anastasia Brow Pro palette. I've had this for a couple of years and I tend to use it every once in a while, but the past month or so, this is all I've been using on my brows. I was using the brow definer for a little bit and then I just started using this. Like, this is all that I have on my brows today. And I just love how natural the brow powder looks, and I feel like it's a lot easier if you mess up to use brow powder. So this palette comes with all 11 of their brow powder shades, so if you're a makeup artist or you freelance, this would be great for your kit. I definitely recommend having this in your kit. It is a little bit pricey. I think it's $88, but for me, I like it because first of all, my eyebrows are black, and if you have black eyebrows, it can be hard to find colors to fill in your brows. I got some questions on my last video asking why I don't use like a black powder for my eyebrows, but black is just too harsh in my opinion. Like, I don't want my eyebrows to look black even though my hair is black. Usually when you have dark hair, you want your brows to be about one shade lighter, but my actual brow hairs are black, so I like to use more of a taupey brown color to fill in my brows just so it looks a little bit softer. I usually use a combination of the dark brown for the front part of my brow, and then I use the darkest shade of the ebony for the back part of my brow, because if you guys have seen me without makeup on, I don't have a whole lot of brow hairs above my brow, but I like a fuller brow look, so I'll use that dark color. It's just a dark brown, and I like to use that to kind of create the shape that I want. It also comes with the brow primer that is right here, and then even like whenever I had an ombre, I liked this because I could use different shades for my brows, because when my hair was lighter, my brows were also lighter. So I just love this, and it's just reignited my love for their brow powders. I haven't been using the Brow Wiz or any brow pencils just this the past month, so these are the Anastasia brow powders. Next, I have the Laura Mercier Cream Contour Kit. This is another product I know I've mentioned before, but I re-fell in love with it the past month because I've been doing a lot of cream contouring. I've been going mainly between this and the Tarte Tartis Contour Palette. So this is the inside of the palette. I usually use the medium 2 shade, which is the one right here next to the yellowish highlight color. I love about this contour palette is the formula. Like, the formula is everything. If you've been wanting to try cream contouring, or you're nervous, or you're a beginner, this is hands down the best contour kit that I have ever used in my entire life because it's so blendable and it's so user-friendly. In my experience with cream contouring kits, I feel like it's hard to find that happy medium. Some of them are too pigmented and then it looks like there's mud all over your face. And then some of them aren't pigmented enough and they're kind of dry. This is just the best formula out of all of the cream contour kits that I have tried. It's almost like a moussey cream, but it's still like stiff enough to where it's like you're not gonna pick up too much product. product, if that makes sense. When you apply this, it just looks so natural, and I like to dip my brush and just blend and apply at the same time. Like, you don't have to apply the lines and then blend it out. With this product, I do it all at the same time because it is just so beautiful, and it sits on the skin so nicely, and it doesn't look orange, it doesn't look muddy. It just looks amazing, and it's really easy to use. Sometimes I get discouraged with cream contouring because I feel like it just takes too long and I don't have that much time, but this is just like the best. Now, I haven't used the highlight shades. There's the gold highlight and then also this more of a bronzy one. Sorry, I'm blinding you. I haven't used those. I've only used the contour shades, and I love, love, love them. So I just wanted to mention it because I've been using it nonstop. So this is the Laura Mercier Cream Contour Kit. You guys, this is my baby. This is my baby. I'm obsessed with this, and this is the Dior highlight that I used in my last tutorial, and I think that it's sold out, which makes me really sad, really, really sad. So here is, oh my gosh, I can't even, like, look at that. It's blinding my camera. It's so intense. This is the Dior Glowing Nude Highlight. I picked mine up at Sephora, like, in store, so I think Sephora still has it. If I can find it, I will link it down in the description bar. This is the highlight I have on my cheekbones right now. Like, it is... literally, this is the best highlight I've ever used in my entire life. Which, you guys know, coming from me, that is a bold statement. The best highlight I've ever used in my life. And it is pricey, it's Dior, but it is so worth it. I thought the formula was gonna be more powdery because it kind of looks like the Anastasia highlights, but when you apply it, it is just so skin-like and so foiled. And I apply it with MAC Fix Plus. I spray my brush with a little bit of that water and then apply it, and it just is amazing. And like, do you see the pattern that's embossed? I mean, I kind of messed it up because I use this every single day, but honestly, you guys, like, honestly, if you can find this, it is hands down worth it. Like, I should have bought a backup. I hands down should have gotten a backup, but it is just the perfect light gold shade to where it doesn't look dirty or too gold on your face. You know what I'm saying? Like, Laura Geller Gilded Honey is another one of my favorites. I wear that a lot as well. But if I'm not tan enough, I feel like sometimes, like, from the front of my face, it looks a little bit like it looks gold. It doesn't look like highlight bling, you know? I don't know. I hope that makes sense. But this highlight is bomb. So next, I have some lashes to show you guys. These have been my favorite lashes. Like, these are the only ones I've worn the past month besides my Coco Goddess occasionally, but I have been wearing these nonstop. I actually met the founder. These are from Blinking Beauté Lashes, and I actually met the founder at the NYX opening in San Jose, and she was so sweet and just really good vibes. Like, you know, when you meet someone and you can kind of felt their vibes, and she was just such a nice person, like, so, so sweet. So anyways, I got to try some of her lashes, and I love them. These are premium mink lashes, but they're also cruelty-free. And when it comes to lashes, I mean, mink just look the most realistic, and I think they look the best, and these are no exception. So I'm actually wearing some today. Today I'm wearing the number 7 lashes. These are the first time that I'm wearing these. These lashes have little gaps in between, so they look a lot more natural, and today I was going for a little bit more of a natural look. But the ones that I've been wearing nonstop are these two styles. Number 2, these are just gorge. And these aren't typically what I tend to go for because they're pretty full throughout the entire band, if you guys can see. Like, they're pretty full all the way out. And I usually like to have ones that are thinner and get bigger, but these are so, so pretty. They just make my eyes look almost a little bit bigger than they are. And then I love, love, love the Samantha lash. These are so intense and so glamorous. Like, these with winged eyeliner are just bomb. Like, they are so thick, but they feel so light on the eyes. Like, they don't feel extremely heavy, and also they're really comfortable. So I was able to get a coupon code for you guys if you guys want to try it out, because mink lashes are more on the pricey side. So if you use the code Amanda, you will get 10% off. Hooked you up. Try them. So next is the new Little Nude Beauty Blender. Mine is dirty, but look at how cute it is. You guys know, like, I am so in love with beauty blenders. They're so cute, but I mean, in addition to being cute, they make my makeup just look bomb. Like, it makes my foundation and concealer look flawless. Like, I usually use it for foundation, for concealer, and then I'll use it to pick up my powder to bake and set my concealer. Like, it just does everything, and it's just so cute. This one's dry, so it's smaller, but obviously when you wet it, it like doubles in size. So I saw these on Sephora's website, and I was like, oh my gosh, I need them. And they were sold out. So I went into my Sephora and they had them. So I actually picked up two of them because I was afraid that I wasn't going to be able to get them. But when I checked yesterday, they were back in stock online. So they should be in stock. I'll link the nude ones down below. But I was just so excited for a nude color. One, because I love nude. It's one of my favorite colors or tones, whatever. But also, I feel like it doesn't look quite as dirty for me. Now, if you're darker skin tone, obviously the foundation's going to show up. But for me, since I'm not that tan right now, it just looks a lot more pleasing. Like, does that sound weird? I just hate the pink beauty blender gets so dirty and it just bugs me. Also, have you guys ever noticed with the pink beauty blender, the first time you wash it, there's like pink dye in the water and that freaks me out. So that's why I usually stick with the black one, but now the nude one. And I've used it the past couple of weeks and I love it so much. It works just as good as the other ones, but I just want to show it in case you guys didn't know they came out with one because it's so cute. You guys know my obsession with Olive is so real. Like every time I leave my house now and I go to grab a shirt, it's Olive. And I'm like, Amanda, you have to stop. But I ain't gonna stop because I love it. You guys didn't know this, but I've been on the hunt for a good Olive nail polish for at least a month now. It was so funny because one of my friends, Matthew, was at Ulta and he saw this. He was like, you need this. It's the perfect Olive nail polish. And in the pictures, it looked a little bit more gray. And even in the bottle, I don't know how it picks up on camera, it looks almost more of a gray green. But literally, like on the nails, it is perfection. I just got my nails done a couple days ago and I got Olive again and I had Olive last time. Like, it's a huge deal for me when I do the same nail polish color twice because I always change it up, and this is the second time I've gotten this. This is Zoya Charlie. I don't know if I said the name yet or not, but it's C-H-A-R-L-I. I'll link it down below. This color is just bomb and it's so flattering because Olive can definitely be a tricky color to wear if it's like more of a mossy olive or more of a dark olive. Like, you want that perfect neutral olive that just kind of goes with everything, and that is this color. So moving on to lip products, the first one I have is Dulce K from Kylie Cosmetics. I love this color. It is just the perfect nude brown. Like, it just looks so flattering and the formula lasts a really long time. It is dry. Like, I will say the Kylie liquid lips are really, really drying, but they have to be a little bit dry in order to stay on your lips. I did buy all the colors last time that she launched her products. The only one I haven't liked so far, I'm just gonna put a disclaimer out there, is Mary Jo. The color was beautiful, but on me, it just flaked and patched off. I know I talked about it on Snapchat. I don't know if I got a bad one or what, because I know a lot of people love that color, but mine just like will not stay on my lips. Like, it just patches and like literally flaked off. I've never had that happen before. Anyways, but I have been loving Dulce K. I'm gonna swatch it on my hand for you guys. I feel like my favorite colors to wear on my lips are rosy mauve colors and then brown shades. Like, whether it's a dark brown, light brown, I just love brown colors. And I wanted this during the first launch and I couldn't get it. But this color is so, so stunning and it's so flattering on so many different skin tones. Here is also the lip liner. I love her lip pencils. They are so creamy and so just easy to wear. So there's the lip pencil and the liquid lip. Next is Jeffree Star Cosmetics Celebrity Skin Liquid Lipstick. This is another color I have worn so much. I wore it every time I've traveled the past couple of months. I've worn it in my Q&A video, I've worn it on Snapchat a lot. And in the tube, I mean, it's like really nude, but it has a pinkish brown undertone, which makes it really wearable. So here is Celebrity Skin. You can see it's a little bit more on the nude side than Dulce K. I don't know what one it is, but yeah, I love it, girl. Next, I have Joseph Colors Cork Liquid Lipstick. I know I briefly mentioned this last month, but this has been another staple color for me. It is a beautiful light brown. Like, I don't have anything like it, and I love it so much. Like, I've worn it with a smoky eye, but then I've also worn it with more of a natural look, and I love it. It's just such a warm, beautiful chestnut brown color, and I didn't think I was gonna like it that much just looking at the swatches online before I got it, but then once I started wearing it, it is just so flattering. I wore this to my NYX New Jersey meetup that I had, and everyone was asking what color was, and it was Dose of Colors Cork. I've just worn it a ton, and I love it so, so much, and it doesn't budge, and it's just such a unique color. Like, I feel like lots of colors out there, there's dupes for them, but I don't know of a dupe for this color. It is amazing. Surprisingly, I've worn a lot of red lips this month. Like, I've worn red lips a couple of times, which I rarely wear, like a bright red lip, unless it's closer to holidays or summertime, but I can't get enough of this lip color. This is also from Dose of Colors, and this is Merlot. I've had it forever, but I just never wore it, and I wore it on Valentine's Day, and then I wore it this weekend, and then I wore it some other time. Oh, I wore it at the NYX Cosmetics store opening in New Jersey, and I am just in love with it. It's the perfect classic red color, but it's really bright and vibrant, so it doesn't look like too dull, it doesn't look too orange or too dark. Like, it is just the perfect red shade. Like, it just looks beautiful, and it makes your teeth look really white. You have to be careful with red sometimes, because sometimes if they're too orange, they can make your teeth look a little bit funky. So you wanna make sure you have a good, stable red color, and Merlot is my fave. So my last lip product is one that I've mentioned before, but I wanna quickly mention it because when I wore this, I don't know that I've ever had so many questions about what lip gloss I was wearing than when I wore this. I wore this a few weeks ago. It was the first night I went to Jersey, and we got to go to like a NYX little like private party and like look at the store. I wore that long olive green dress, and I was wearing just this lip gloss under Kylie's Dulce K lip pencil. Literally, you guys, I've never had so many people ask me what lip color you're wearing, and this is the Gerard lip gloss in Plum Crazy. Plum Crazy, Nude, Cocoa Bean, and then I'm wearing Shimmer of Hope today. These are my favorite lip glosses from them. I've just worn them forever, and they're just really, really good quality, and I feel like they stick really well. But this is Plum Crazy. It's one of my favorite colors. I've worn it for years. So you can see there is the gloss color, and I love how pigmented they are. They are just so pigmented, and they have enough stickiness to them that they just stay on your lips and they just last. Like, I've been wearing this one for an hour and a half, and I've been talking and doing other things, and it just still stays on. I'm wearing Shimmer of Hope today. And I do have a coupon code for them. I'll link it down below if you're interested. But this was the gloss that I was wearing that night. It's just the perfect mauve-y rose color, and it has like a hint of brown. I love this with like a really natural eye or a really smoked out eye. It just makes your lips look awesome. So I have two fashion favorites this month, and the first one is my New York hat. I love this hat. I know you guys are probably sick of seeing it, but I love it. Like, whether I'm traveling, every time I've been traveling, I've worn it. If your hair is dirty or you don't want anyone to see your face, a hat solves everything. Like, literally put my hair in a pony, put my hat on, or maybe just put it on with my hair down, and I just feel like I am good to go, because then I can kind of like lay low and I don't have to worry about my face or anything. You guys feel me. You know how it is. I bought mine from PacSun. I know that after I mentioned it on Snapchat and Instagram and that it's sold out, which is insane. It's sold out online, but I'll check to see if it's not in stock yet. Maybe you guys can get it like a Lids, a Dick's, or something, like one of those sports kind of stores, because it's just like a Yankees hat. Like, someone has to have it, but I love it. Like, the color, the fit, it just looks really cute. I'm really weird about my hats if they don't fit right. You know what I'm saying? Like, some just don't fit your head right. This, like, I wear like every single day. I love it. So wanted to mention this hat. And then next are my favorite caged heels. I love these. I feel like I've worn them in the past couple of my OOTD pictures I posted on Instagram. They're just my go-to shoes. And these are from Ego UK. It's Ego Official, I believe, on Instagram. These are where I got my Feezy shoes. It's the same brand. I have a few other pairs of caged heels, but this pattern is my favorite. Just the way that the cutouts are in the, it's a faux suede. It's kind of like a honeycomb, like, you know what I'm saying, and I just love how that looks. I have other caged heels, but they're like crisscross, which I really like this one the most. I feel like it's the most flattering on your feet, and it makes me look like a little bit taller, makes my legs look a little bit longer, and they're super comfortable, and they're super inexpensive in my opinion. I still have a coupon code for them. It's just Amanda, and I think it's 10% off as well. You can just use that, and it's 10% off anything on their website. You guys know what time it is. Let's do some music favorites, and you guys can follow me on Spotify if you want. It's just Amanda Ensing. If you type in my name, it should come up under users. So I do have some throwbacks this month too. So this is my current favorite song right now, hands down. Everybody around me saying I should relax, cause I've been going hard till my eyes roll back. Even if they had a million dollars, they'd be trapping.
Drop it like it's hot, drop it like,
oh my gosh, I just can't wait. You know I ain't showing love unless I'm getting paid.
Work, 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 work. Send me out.
do work.
If you had a twin, I would still choose you. Your saint, your God is the cutest, the hottest. That all I need in this life is your crazy love.
I got time if you got time. When you made me yours, I made you mine. If this is the way it is, don't even put me through it. I'm quick to cut it off if you don't believe I'll do it. Here's the pictures.
So those are all my favorites for the month. I really hope you guys enjoy this video. Don't forget to hit subscribe down below if you haven't. And until my next one, you guys can always find me on my other social media platforms. You guys know I'm always on Instagram and Twitter, and I'm always on Snapchat. The filters are like my life right now, especially the dog filter. The dog filter is my favorite. You guys know this. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. I love you, and I'll see you in my next video. No bueno.
Okay, bye.
Rips. Oh my gosh. I can't believe I did that.